transfer operations. In that, we see about the solute recovery and fractionation. If one group of components constitutes the solvent and the other group the solute, the separation according to these groups are easy, and it is solute recovery, or we call it as solute removal operation. If component property differences are small, fractionation is the technique used to separate pure components. So depending upon the property chosen, we have to select solute recovery or fractionation. So we can choose solute recovery operation or fractionation operation depending upon the properties. So first thing is unsteady state operation. The operation in which concentrations at any point in the apparatus change with time is known as unsteady state operation. So if you take any apparatus, in that the concentration will change at any point according to the time taken, it's known as unsteady state operation. This may result from changes in concentrations of feed materials, flow rates, or conditions of temperature or pressure. So based on these conditions, the concentrations will change. So the batch operations are always of unsteady state type. So you can take batch operations, batch reactors, etc. They're almost unsteady state type. Then steady state operation. The operation in which the concentrations at any position in the apparatus remains constant with passage of time is known as steady state operation. So if you take any of the apparatus, in that the concentration will remain constant with respect to time, then it is steady state operation. So this requires a continuous invariable flow of all phases into and out of the apparatus. So continuously the flow should happen, and also constant concentrations of feed streams and unchanging conditions of temperature as well as pressure. Next thing is stage-wise operation. If two insoluble phases come into contact so that various diffusing substances can distribute themselves between the phases, and if the phases are mechanically separated, the entire operation and the equipment required to carry it out constitutes one stage. So simply we are defining this one stage here. So two insoluble phases, they come into contact and the diffusing substances move between the phases, and these phases are separated. So that operation is considered as one stage. So for separations requiring greater concentration changes, then we use a series of stages arranged or assembled from assembled. Then that assemblage is called cascade. So if you need more concentration changes, we have to take a cascade system. The equilibrium ideal or theoretical stage is defined as one where the effluent phases are in equilibrium, so that a longer time of contact will give no additional change of composition. So simply we are defining the theoretical stage or ideal stage. The approach to the equilibrium realized in any stage is defined as the stage of efficiency. So we can see further in detail about the stage of efficiency. Then continuous contact operation. The phases flow through the equipment in continuous intimate contact without repeated physical separation and recontacting. So there is no physical separation or recontacting. The phases will flow through the equipment in continuous intimate contact. Then it is continuous contact operation. So this operation is either semi-batch or steady state, and changes in composition are equivalent to fraction of ideal stage, or we can take number of many stages. Equilibrium occurs anywhere in the system, and the result is equivalent to the effect of infinite number of stages. In this operation, the departure from the equilibrium is maintained, and the diffusional flow between the phases continue without interruption. So you can maintain the departure from the equilibrium, and diffusional flow will be continuously happening between the phases. If stage efficiency is low, then continuous contact method is more desirable depending upon the cost and certainty. If it is high, then we go for the other operation. Next one is design principles. Here we have to consider four major factors in the design of any plant involving the diffusional operations. First one is number of equilibrium stages, the time of phase contact required, the permissible rate of flow, and the energy requirements. These are the four major factors which we have to keep in point. First one is number of equilibrium stages. So to estimate this number of equilibrium stages required in a cascade to get a specified degree of separation, the equilibrium characteristics of the system should be known, and also the material balance calculations are required. Based on these two, we have to calculate the number of equilibrium stages. Next one is time requirement. In stage-wise operations, the time of contact is connected with stage efficiency. In continuous contact equipment, time indicates the volume or length of the required device. So for a given degree of intimacy of contact of the phases, the time of contact required is independent of the total quantity of the phases to be processed. Next one is permissible flow rate. This factor, it considers semi-batch and steady state operations and determines the cross-sectional area of the equipment. So here the fluid dynamics establish the permissible flow rate, and material balances determine the quantity of each of the streams required. Final one is energy requirements. So as all you know, heat and mechanical energies are required to carry out the diffusional operations. Heat is necessary for the production of temperature changes, for the creation of new phases, and also for overcoming heat of solution effects. Mechanical energy is required for fluid and solid transport, for dispersing liquids and gases. So the ultimate design requires to deal with the equilibrium characteristics of the system, material balances, diffusional rates, fluid dynamics, and finally energy requirements. So if you deal with all these points, then we can design the required equipment. So this is about the basics of the mass transfer operations. In further chapters, we will see the details of these topics. So how the diffusional characteristics will vary, everything, the different points depending for the required for the ultimate design of the equipment will be studied further. So this is the today's topic. If you like my description, please subscribe my channel. Please like, share, and comment my videos. Please click the bell icon to get the further notifications. Thank you very much.